He doesn't deserve to be in a place like this. Arvak, my horse. We came to this horrible place together. We were attacked by monsters, so I told him to run. Please, he's such a loyal creature, and he's been running for so long. You have to save him. A place like this will change you. Arvak! Arvak! Where are you? Arvak, please come back! Come back!
I trust your journey was successful. I'm sorry, my friend. I can no longer be of use in this matter. It's my fault. In my haste to read the first scroll, I neglected the careful preparation required. I thought I'd be able to allay the after effects, but I was wrong. Now I am paying for it. Blind? Yes, I'm afraid so. No, it will have to run its course. And there's always the chance I may never recover. No, there is another way. The question is, how much are you willing to risk to find Oriel's bow? I can't guarantee you'd be free from harm. Becoming blind could be the least of your worries. Scattered across Tamriel are secluded locations known only as Ancestor Glades. There's one in Skyrim, in the Pine Forest. Performing the ritual of the Ancestor Moth within the glade should provide the answers you seek. It involves carefully removing the bark from a canticle tree, which will in turn attract Ancestor Moths to you. Once enough of the moths are following, they'll provide you with the second sight needed to decipher the scrolls. In keeping with tradition, you must use a specific tool in the Ancestor Glade, an implement known as a draw knife. Every Morph Priest is taught this ritual, but few ever get the chance to perform it. You should consider yourself fortunate if it works for you. From what I saw in the vision, the Elder Scroll which foreshadows the defiance of the gods with the blood of mortals is the key to the prophecy. Sadly, yes. It is the inevitable fate we agree to pursue when reading the Elder Scrolls. It generally does not occur until a Morph Priest is in his latter years, but in my case, I simply was not preparing myself properly. Deciphering one of the Elder Scrolls is nothing like reading a simple book. There is quite a bit of ritual and concentration required. It can take months or even years to complete a single scroll, and even then, months to recover. Well, as I'm sure you've figured out by now, it's no mere coincidence that we're named Morph Priests. The voice of the Ancestor Morph has always been an integral part of reading the Elder Scrolls. Oh, the Morphs don't literally read the scrolls. But they maintain a connection to ancient magic that allows the Morph Priests to decipher them. If you listen closely when you find the glade, you should be able to hear their song, a soft, harmonious trilling. It's through this ancestral chorus that the Morphs tap into a form of primal augur and become a conduit for deciphering the scrolls. By having the Ancestor Morphs close to the Morph Priest, they can utilize the conduit and share the Morph's augury. Only the most resilient of priests can do it this way. It takes years of practice to interpret the harmony. You've come this far, and you've found several Elder Scrolls. Whether you believe it or not, the scrolls have a mind of their own. If they did not want you to find them, they would not allow it. Because of this, I strongly believe you were meant to hear the ancestral chorus. Only one way to find out. Good luck. I hope you find the answers you seek.
Sorry. Not very impressive, is it? If this ends up being a wasted trip, we send Dexian and I are gonna have some words when we get back. And said they would. Look at them. They've definitely taken a liking to you. And unless I'm seeing things, you're starting to glimmer. Whoa. I think that might have been what we were waiting for. Let's head back up there and see if we can read the scrolls. Nervous? Okay, I almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow. Are you okay? I almost thought I lost you there. You went as white as the snow. I never trusted those damn scrolls. Who knows what those things could have done to you? Just look at Dexian. What about Ariel's bow? Do you know where we can find it? Then it's almost over. We can finally put an end to this ridiculous prophecy. Where is this Darkfall cave? Then let's get going. I want to get there before my father has a chance to track us down. I'm right behind you.
Thank you.
yourself. There you are.
Come forward. You have nothing to fear here. I am Knight Paladin Gellibor. Welcome to the Great Chantry of Auriel. Auriel, Auriel, Alkosh, Akatosh, so many different names for the Sovereign of the Snow Elves. I prefer Snow Elf. The name Falmer usually holds a negative meaning to most travelers. Those twisted creatures you call Falmer, I call the Betrayed. Of course, you're here for Auriel's bow. Why else would you be here? I can help you get it, but first, I must have your assistance. For the thousands of years I've served as the Chantry's Sentinel, there hasn't been a single visitor here for any other reason. They request Auriel's bow, and I request their assistance. It's been repeated so many times, I can't imagine it any other way. I need you to kill Archcurate Werther, my brother. The kinship between us is gone. I don't understand what he's become, but he's no longer the brother I once knew. It was the Betrayed. They did something to him. I just don't know why Auriel would allow this to happen. They swept into the Chantry without warning, and began killing everyone without pause. The Chantry was a place of peaceful worship. I led a small group of paladins, but we were no match for the Betrayed's sheer numbers. They slaughtered everyone and stormed the inner sanctum where I believe they corrupted Werther. He's alive. I've seen him, but something's wrong. He never looks as though he's in pain or under duress. He just stands there and watches, as though waiting. Leaving the way shrines unguarded would be violating my sacred duty as a Knight Paladin of Auriel, and an assault on the betrayed guarding the inner sanctum would only end with my death. Yes, let me show you. And for transport when the Chantry was a place of enlightenment. Prelates of these shrines were charged with teaching the mantras of Auriel to our initiates.
What's that basin in the center signify?
Once the initiate completed his mantras, he'd dip a ceremonial ewer in the basin at the Way Shrine center and proceed to the next Way Shrine.
So these initiates had to lug around a heavy pitcher of water. Marvelous. How long would they have to do that?
Once the initiate's enlightenment was complete, he'd bring the ewer to the Chantry's inner sanctum. Pouring the contents of the ewer into the sacred basin of the sanctum would allow him to enter for an audience with the Arch-Curate himself.
All that just to end up dumping it out? Makes no sense to me.
It's symbolic. I don't expect you to understand.
So, let's get this straight. We need to do all that nonsense to get into the temple so we can kill your brother and claim Auriel's bow.
I know how it all sounds. But if there was another way, I'd have done it long ago. The only way to get to my brother is by following in the initiate's footsteps and traveling from Way Shrine to Way Shrine, just as they did. The first lay at the end of Darkfall Passage, a cavern that represents the absence of enlightenment. There are five in total, spread far apart across the Chantry. Caves? Oh no. The Chantry encompasses far more than a few caves, as you'll soon discover. But before I send you on your way, you'll need the initiate's ewer. Once you've located a way shrine, there'll be a spectral prelate tending to it. They will allow you to draw the waters from the shrine's basin, as if you've been enlightened. This may be the last time we're able to converse. If you have any questions before you leave, I suggest you ask them. Otherwise, all I can do now is grant you my hopes for a safe journey. Questions? I expected as much. This is, or was, the epicenter of our religion. Most of the Snow Elf people worshipped Auriel. The Chantry was constructed near the beginning of the First Era, to provide a retreat for those that wish to become enlightened. Our empire had temples to some of the other deities. Trinimac, Cerebane, Yefrey, and Finister rounded out the rest. But those temples paled in comparison to the glory of the Chantry and its way shrines. Oh yes, they were an important part of the process here. They represented the steps the initiates took on the path to total enlightenment. Sadly, the magic used to construct these wonders were lost long before I arrived here. We were once a wealthy and prosperous society that occupied a portion of Skyrim. Unfortunately, we were constantly at war with the Nords, who claimed the land as their ancestral home. In a manner of speaking, we had always maintained an uneasy alliance with the underground-dwelling dwarves, and when faced with extinction, we turned to them for help. Surprisingly, they agreed to protect us, but demanded a terrible price. The blinding of our race. There were splinter groups that resisted the agreement, and even some that sought alternate alliances. But when it was all said and done, those elves were either slaughtered, vanished, or gave up and took the dwarves' bargain. I've often asked myself that very same question. The blinding of my race was supposedly accomplished with a toxin, certainly not enough to devolve them into the sad and twisted beings they've become. May Auriel keep you free from harm.
That pleasant as I thought it would be. Kind of soothing, actually. I feel a little warmer now.
Done.
Wait.
Welcome, Initiate. This is the Way Shrine of Illumination. Are you prepared to honor the mantras of Ariel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment? Then behold Ariel's gift, my child. May it light your path as you seek tranquility within the Inner Sanctum. Welcome, Initiate. This is the way. Then behold Ariel's gift, my child. May it speed your journey to the Inner Sanctum. Light guide you in your darkest hours. The mantras of Ariel and fill your vessel with his enlightenment. Ariel bless you, child, for you are a step closer to the Inner Sanctum and everlasting wisdom. Warmth imbue your body with strength. May Ariel's warmth imbue your body with strength. you've arrived at the Way Shrine of Resolution. Then go forth, child. May the enrichment of Ariel strengthen your resolve as you undertake your journey to the Inner Sanctum.
Thank you.
This must be that beautiful Skyrim weather I've always heard about.
Thank you.
found the Way Shrine of Ra- May the blessings of Ariel protect you as you climb the road to the inner sanctum and final enlightenment.
Get indoors, or in a cave, anywhere. Out of this.
May Ariel's brilliance illuminate your path. May Ariel's radiance fill your heart with joy.
I've never seen a building like that. It looks like something. I never saw anything like that. This is a statue of Ariel, but it's using the older signs of his power. This temple must be ancient. The bow has to be in here. Sorry.
Did you really come here expecting to claim Ariel's bow? You've done exactly as I predicted and brought your fetching companion to me.
Wait, is he talking about me?
Which, I'm sorry to say, means your usefulness is at an end! impressive display, but a wasted effort. You delay nothing but your own deaths.
Watch out! He's falling down the ceiling! Enough further. Give us the bow.
How dare you? I was the arch-curate of Ariel, girl. I had the ears of a god.
Until the betrayed corrupted you. Yes, yes, we've heard this sad story.
Gellibor and his kind are easily manipulated fools. Look into my eyes, Serana. You tell me what I am.
You're a vampire? But Ariel should have protected you.
The moment I was infected by one of my own initiates, Ariel turned his back on me. I swore I'd have my revenge, no matter what the cost.
You want to take revenge on a god?
Ariel himself may have been beyond my reach, but his influence on our world wasn't. All I needed was the blood of a vampire and his own weapon, Ariel's bow.
The blood of a vampire, Ariel's bow. It was you? You created that prophecy?
A prophecy that lacked a single final ingredient, the blood of a pure vampire, the blood of a daughter of Cold Harbor.
All this time for someone with my blood to come along. Well, too bad for you. I intend on keeping it. Let's see if your blood has any power to it.
Oh,
no. You will not touch me.
So the deed has been done. The restoration of this way shrine means that Werther must be dead, and the betrayed no longer have control over him.
What?
What are you talking about? A vampire. I see. That would explain much. Deep inside, it brings me joy that the betrayed weren't to blame for what happened here. Because that means there's still hope that they might one day shed their hatred and learn to believe in Auriel once again. It's been a long time since I felt that way, and it's been long overdue. My thanks to both of you. You risked everything to get Auriel's bow, and in turn, you've restored the Chantry. I can't think of a more deserving champion to carry it than you. If you wish to learn more about the bow, or obtain Sunhallowed arrows for it, I'd be more than happy to help. You've but to ask. Trust you're faring well.
It's not as shiny as I was expecting. Still, it's beautiful. I think we both know. It's time to face my father. If we don't, he'll keep chasing us for the rest of our lives. I've been thinking about this for a long time. It's not easy, but I don't think we have much of a choice. No, this has to end here and now. If we head back to the castle and kick the front door in, we're gonna be knee-deep in his friends. Let's head back to Isran and let him see what we've got first. I'm betting he'll lend us a sword or two.
If there's assistance I can provide, just ask. It's the least I can do.
Honored to see you again, my Thane.
Thank you.
Ariel's bow. Indeed. The day hasn't been won while Harkon still walks Tamriel. But what of Serana? Can she be trusted to lift the blade against her own kind, her own family? I suppose that's as much as I can hope for. Let me address the Dawn Guard and then we'll be off. The men deserve to know that we finally gained the upper hand.
Everyone, gather round. Come on then, we haven't got all day.
I knew it would come to this one day. I knew. And no one believed. Keep your eyes open. Be on your guard at all times. Avoid sleep if you can. Sleep is for the weak. Keep your eyes open.
For too long, we've allowed these vampires to poison the night and kill our people. Now, we finally have the means to strike back. We now have Ariel's bow. The gods themselves have favored us, and we must answer with action. The time has come to finally put an end to Harkon and his unholy prophecy. We will march on their lair and destroy those wretched abominations so they can no longer corrupt our world. This is our fight, and this is our fate. This is the time of the Dawn Guard! Kill the abominations!
This is the Dawn Guard! Between the eyes for me! Set them up after them.
It's time we take the fight to their door. Gather your things and rest well, my friend. We meet outside Castle Volgahar. Watch your back.
Just get to their master.
For the Dawn Guard. Skyrim!
We'll secure the castle. You just get to their master.
No vampire in one piece.
The Dawn Guard! The Skyrim!
Serana, my darling. I see you still favor keeping a pet.
You know why we're here.
Of course I do. You disappoint me, Serana. You've taken everything I provided for you and thrown it all away for this pathetic being.
Provided for me? Are you insane? You've destroyed our family. You've killed other vampires, all over some prophecy that we barely understand. No more. I'm done with you. You will not touch him.
So, I see this dragon has fangs. Your voice drips with the venom of your mother's influence. How alike you've become.
No. Because unlike her, I'm not afraid of you. Not anymore.
And you. It appears I have you to thank for turning my daughter against me. I knew it was only a matter of time before she'd return with hatred in her heart. A small price to pay for the betterment of our kind. Yes, yes. Always the noble vampire hunter. And what happens when you've slain me? Is Valerica next? Is Serana?
I see. Interesting that you can set aside your morals when it suits you. Yes, quite. I'm growing weary of speaking to you and my traitorous daughter. I'll give you a single chance to turn over the bow to me. There will not be a second.
Very well, then. You leave me no choice.
It's done. I'm not sure. I'll probably stay with the Dawn Guard for as long as they'll let me. They're respectable fighters, and I think they see the benefits of having a vampire on their side now. Of course, if you've got any more adventures planned... That's what I wanted to hear. Sounds like that's the last bit of the prophecy. The blood of a daughter of Cold Harbor can corrupt the bow. Sure. Do you have any arrows, though? They would have to be of elven quality, I guess. Let's just get this over with. I'll be with the Dawn Guard if you need me.
So, the beast is destroyed. Not only that, it's over. He's dead. And the prophecy dies with him. I suppose this is difficult for you.
I think my father really died a long time ago. This was just the end of something else. I did what needed to be done. Nothing more.
I think you did more than that. You have my thanks.
Yes?
Thank you.